Greetings, viewers. Thanks for joining me out in the shop today. Getting ready to do some work on the Tundra. And as you can see, I jumped in and got started. Yes, I have removed my beloved Ivan Stewart kit. I love the Ivan Stewart kit, but I've always kind of hated rust catchers, but I thought those color match flares looked so good, I left them on. One of them worked its way loose and I pulled it out and looked behind it, and that's what I saw on my freaking wonderful, beloved Tundra. I'm not happy about that, but fortunately, that's the only fender. Yeah, I got to get all this rubbery stuff off. Yeah, I'll probably take that body side molding off, but I'm not sure. But up front here, I got the big chrome bumper off that was underneath of it, and I'm going to get started building a front bumper and sliders. Yes, it's finally time to get busy on the Tundra. I have a nice little pile of parts I've been adding up. Previous owner gave me rear brake shoes. I'm going to put those on. I bought this locker, this Detroit or Eaton True Track. Oh gosh, 13 months ago now. This is the install kit to install and set it up. That's getting ready to happen. I got me a dash cam finally with front and rear view cameras. That's going to be cool. New stereo. I said I was going to upgrade the stereo. This is what I bought myself when I sold the Tacoma as my payment for all the work I did, was the camera and the stereo. The rest of this I've been adding up. Of course, I got the extended travel CVs I'm getting ready to put in there, as one of mine has slung another boot clamp off and lost a bunch of grease. I guess that's part of the lifted truck blues. Hopefully this will eliminate all that. I'll probably take that diff drop back out at the same time. Oswald and Slim are both out here ready to help. I did go ahead and pull that bumper cover off. It's just held on to this with some push fasteners here and two screws on the end and some sticky tape on the back. It came right off. It's in great condition. If you know anybody interested in it, hit me up in the comments, because I am going to get rid of it, I think. I'd love to make wall art out of it if nobody wants it, though. We'll see how all that goes. So this front fender is good. This front fender was starting to get rust here where it wore the paint off. I'm glad I took these off and stopped it. Yeah, I really love that Ivan Stewart package and the rareness of it. But both of these rear ones, this one started to get a little rust around the bottom there. Anyway, sliders. Got my material over here. Ready for sliders. Ready for bumpers. I don't know where you live. And I don't know when you're actually even seeing this video, but right now in February here in Indiana, steel prices are way down, which is bad for me when I scrap stuff, but good for me when I want to fab stuff, because I can get the materials for a lot less. Now, I got my stock skid plate off. Oswald wants to make it a sled, it looks like. This is the bar that held that front skid plate on, and that's coming off. There were two bolts there and over there. The bottom one put up a little bit of a fight, and you see who won that battle. Those held this little crash protection bar thing on that was behind the bumper. That gives you a little added crash protection. I'm gonna take all that off of there. That's why I had to remove the skid plate. I'm gonna remove that. I'm gonna cut this off and go directly to the frame. I know it's got the crumple zone area right there, but I plan to plate around that and attach my bumper accordingly. I am going to put a winch on here as well. Sliders, traction, and CVs started out to be the only thing. But once I peeled those rust catchers off the sides, the front bumper fascia didn't look right. I'm not getting rid of the grill. I love the grill. So bumper getting ready to be built, eliminating the skid plate here. You know how I do it. I make it all up as I go along. So I'll tune you in as I go along. Getting ready to take this off. Going to find a way to get started because that's the toughest part. All right, so I got the plasma station set up here. I got my welding set up here on the floor. Swept my area real good so I don't get my knees on rocks. That's kind of important when I'm pondering and planning because I make shit up as I go along when I do these. I needed some more distance out, so I welded this 1¼ by, what is that, 3? Yeah, that 1¼ by 3 by 3/8 thick piece on the end. I'm going to tie this on up at the top. I'll probably bring something else across these sides and under the bottom. I'm going to do like a bigger piece on the bottom, similar to this one. Had to stay back because of those hoses. Could have maybe brought it back some more and notched it, but that is not the final on this part of the top. That's just where I'm at so far. I can put my winch on here between this area, which I can put another piece of quarter on top of that, or 3/8 for winch plate. My winch will fit under this if I leave the control box to the side. Since I got such a big flat area there in the middle, I got plenty of room for that. Because you can see over here, just by leaving 20, I think it's 22 inches in the middle, I would have room for this box on this side by the controller, and I believe the cables are long enough for that. If not, maybe under or over here, directly over the motor or something. That's stuff I haven't gotten to yet. I'll probably go to Harbor Freight and get me another one of those Fairlead things, or might make my own this time. This is quarter. This is 3/8. The piece on the bottom is going to be quarter. I will weld it all solid. That'll give me a nice C channel for strength across the front there. I will incorporate these as I bring it up the sides. Probably do something just thin to cover like I did here, but maybe put a brace behind it so it can't fold in because I folded those in and bent those out and brought them back a couple times. This bumper will be different from all the ones I've done before, just because that's how Oswald and I like to do it. He's been trying to chase plasma sparks and getting disciplined for it, so he's not real happy at the moment. Don't worry, I don't beat him too much. No, I don't beat him at all. He's my little buddy, but he can't chase those sparks. I won't allow it anymore. I'm worried for him. So anyway, enough about that. I'm not sure if I'm going to try and use those same fog lights that were in that bumper or get some others. I think getting others and just adding them on would be the best thing to do. I'll get moving some more on this and show you what I got. Yeah, here in a minute. It's going to be nicer, bigger, and beefier than it needs to be. That's the way I like to do them. I'll hit you up when I get some more done. Okay, well, I got my bottom piece on. I got it all welded up nice and solid. I cleaned it up real good and flat there in the middle so that I could mount my winch. I like this bracing underneath here like I did it for this winch, so I'll probably steal that idea and do a similar thing like that to mount my winch, but then all the rest of it will have to be different. All right, viewers, another day, another trip to Harbor Freight. They have a new Badlands winch out now. They have the 12,000 ZXR with the synthetic rope and the synthetic Fairlead and the wireless remote. Well, now they got the ZXR-12. Comes with a wire and a roller Fairlead and no remote. Or no wireless remote, anyway. It's half the price of the ZXR12 with the other features. The remote might be nice. I can add that and synthetic line for still less than what their ZXR12 with all the goodies comes with. So anyway, yeah, thank you Harbor Freight once again. They had one of their rare freaking mounting plates in stock. This has the mounting box that goes up here, but that would make it too tall for what I want it to be. So I'm going to remote mount the box up on the side of the bumper. Of course, I don't have that figured out just yet, but I like this winch and I don't want to cut my grill and I don't want to stick it another 4 inches out. I like my stuff to be tucked up and compact and yeah, like that, but I don't want to chop my grill up. So you can see, you know, you've seen that. So anyway, that's the plan. Oswald doesn't like all the noise that comes with fabricating, but that's the way it goes. Yeah, and that's even actually a little bit higher than I need it to be. So that's the next step I'm going to start with. If you have questions about how it's done, ask. If I don't show it and you think I should, comment. So anyway, enough about that. Let me get started on this. I'll be back, you know, hit the high points. All right. Now, I did a peculiar cut on the end of this here because I have an idea, but I don't know if I'm going to execute it or change it. Down here to hold it, same thing like I did on the other. This will be plated. There'll be the opening here to get to the bolts for the winch. This will be plated in the middle, and then this will be plated over here on the side. Kind of, you know, like that. So anyway, that part will be good. Then I can come back just a little bit into, like, maybe even finish this down at this same angle for my radiator skid plate. So I'm thinking that, but I'm not sure. What I'm going to do coming up the sides, I'm mounting the winch. I'm going to hang the control box in this area right here. And then I'll have to open the hood to plug it in, but it'll come out under and I can leave it plugged in all day or whatever. That is not something I have gotten to yet. We'll see what happens with this. I thought about it and then I don't know. So anyway, I'll just be back to show you some more of what I did. I just got these tacked on for now. Had to cut them all and then you take them all over to the bench and grind them so that they match. All right, viewers, so I've been welding some stuff on. I still haven't filled in the bottom yet. These corners are going to get cut on this piece, but I'm not sure where just yet. I wanted some protection up alongside the winch. I know it doesn't look like much at the moment, but I think it's going to look good when it's done. It's definitely going to be beef. It's all quarter inch. I got an idea for the corners. Again, some of this might get cut. Some of this might get cut. There will be a top, hopefully, up here, a place to set a drink. You never know. I'm not done yet, obviously. And I'm, like I said, I make it up as I go. I highly recommend this method of bumper building. I know people go out and pay $500-$600 for a bumper. I bought enough steel to build the front bumper, the back bumper, and the sliders, and could still buy a new welder every time because I have inexpensive tools, granted, but I could buy a new welder and all the steel and still make cheaper bumpers than you can buy them for. So let me contemplate this while I go have lunch. I'll come out and show you some more. Basically, I've just cut and welded some pieces on. I like it. I think it's going to be nice. It's going to look good. It's the same on both sides. Like I say, it's going to have some trimming done on these pieces, but I had to get it up there so I could see what I thought. And so far, I think I like it. All right, viewers, ready to show you the next part here. This isn't going to make a whole lot of sense to you until it's done. It's going to be way overkill and way beefy. I don't know what I'm going to do on the corners yet, but that looks like it's going to stick out too far. So I got a feeling I'm going to cut this down straight and then go back, but I'm not sure yet. This obviously is my top. I said I wanted a place to put a drink up here. I'm going to have to weld all these solid now. Not necessarily these, but start solid welding some stuff. I still got my plates to put on the front. I'm going to put a two-piece plate on here and have it meet in the middle. There'll be a filler here. Excuse me. When it's done, it'll make more sense. I'm not showing a whole bunch of it. Other than, yeah, kind of some pieces finished as I go. My other bumper builds and slider build videos just really didn't do that well. I guess guys that know how to cut and weld and make their own bumpers don't need to watch me do it. I hope you find this interesting. I'd like to see the end result of this. I'm pretty excited to see it myself, because I'm not sure how it's going to turn out. Oswald's trying to learn how to use power tools and getting his coat all dirty. But anyhow, a lot of extra material for strength where I overlapped some stuff, and I'm going to weld it solid to give it a lot of nice strength. I'll still go from this perch here that used to hold bumper up in the back with something straight for side support, and so it doesn't go this way. Hope all that's showing. Okay, so a little bit more done might make some more sense. A lot of lines, a lot of angles. I like the nice flat up here at the top. I decided to fill this in with an extra piece. Of course, I got lots of welding and grinding to go. I'm really happy with it. Like I said, I like to make it up as I go along. I can't decide if this is too big or it's going to need a chop, but it looks okay. Corners around the bend here, I haven't figured out yet, but I will. I hope that you can see what this is all looking like and how it's going to make sense when it's done. I like the way it dives back in here at the top. I'm going to fill this in somehow over here. But yeah, that's what I've gotten so far. I really like it. It's nice. It's going to be beef. It's all quarter inch or 3/8. The winch part's all 3/8. Not going to stick out too far. Yeah, so that's where I'm at so far. I know it doesn't make a lot of sense when it's all raw metal. I'll get some paint on it. I got a lot of different angles. I like to do angles. Here's one, that's one. Those are all three different to bring it out. These are all different here. I like the way it came together there in the middle once it's all ground down. Part of that was Slim's idea. He wants to get in there and get his credit. Well, all right, viewers, moving on, another day here. I know some of you might be in question as to where did I get this awesome plasma table / welding table. This is a metal piece of lawn furniture on stilts, and I have been using it as my plasma table / welding table for years, where I can just clamp that on there and then make what I need to make. Yeah. You can make your own if you can find one of those kind of tables still. Now, what I've done here, of course, it's still really ugly and has a lot of welds to finish and a few pieces left, like a filler in there. But I've kind of made a rounded corner here, so to speak, with a couple flat edges. This will grind, of course, to flow. Up here, this is an angle. This is an angle, even though these two are really close. This is all three different angles. This is three different angles right here. I did just put a little filler piece in there. That didn't turn out quite like I thought. I got these inside pieces. Yeah, if you see a gap here and there, I'm not afraid to fill a gap. But this is what Oswald and I have come up with. Both sides are not exactly the same. I got a little bigger flat area on this side than I did on the other side, but they look very similar. And yeah, so there you see where I like to have a drink slot up there. I'm gonna leave these angled in just because I like that. It doesn't interfere with the winch. The winch barely fits in there, but it does fit. I got my pieces cut to fill in under, and then I'm going to figure out a little bit of a skid plate, couple reinforcements, and it'll be done. I want you to have a look at it. Hope you like it. Again, I just say I've done several videos showing fabrication builds, and they all go kind of yuck and nobody watches them. So let me know, now that my show is growing some, do you want to see the cutting and welding and measuring part of this? Because when I say I just make these up as I go along, I literally make my winch mount and then I just make up shit and throw it on. That is not the way that works for everybody, but it's the only way that motivates me. If I try to think about it, they end up thinking about it way too long and don't come up with anything. So enough about that. I've talked about that before. I'll tune you back in here in a little bit when I get some more of it welded up. And Oswald wants to play. Yeah, I'll get some more of it welded up, maybe painted, get the winch on it. Next is going to be sliders. I'm going to do those CVs. And you guys have seen me do CVs so many times, I'm probably not going to do them. Yes, I will eventually get to the rust on that quarter panel back there. But not right away because I need the armor and stuff for an upcoming trip. I need it. I want it for an upcoming trip. And I need to get that Eaton Tree Track installed back there. Did want to show, even though I got a flat tire on the T100 now, I did make that fuel system a little better using this tank that came off the back of this one. So I got this tank hooked up, got my return just kind of flopping, and a fuel pump attached to the frame and running down. I have taken this out and driven it around some more. It's funny. It's like a death trap, but it actually drives pretty decent down the road. It has brakes. The shifter's the sloppiest one I've ever seen. You got to fish around for gears, but I can rebuild that. Enough about this. I want a T100 so bad that I wanted to leave this mobile so I could take it around the block when the mood hit me. And I just need to add some air to the tires on it. So still real happy to have that 305 speed rust. Yeah, wow, rust. Anyway, enough about that. You know about my fancy table. I'm really making a mess. The dust and the schlag and the stuff you crack off the side after plasma cutting. I'm getting good at the plasma cutter. Man, I used to really be sucky at it, but the more you do it, the better you get, I guess. So enough about that for right now. Let me do some more on this. I'll tune you into the finished product here. And if you're keeping track at home on the 4Runner, since I've done all the additives, it is still going strong. I've been out 3 times now with it. Well, once on the initial big drive, twice to the park. It's still doing fine. A little tiny rattle at startup still, but it goes away and stays away, and oil pressure stays good the whole time. So that experiment's going well. Oh yeah, more on this. I haven't gotten any further since the last time, but I wanted to give the update on this before I forgot, like I keep forgetting. So still needs some attention in some other places, but the engine's holding up enough to make me want to move forward with other things first. So that. All right, viewers, as you can see, we're moving right along. I'll show you the whole thing here in a minute, but I wanted to talk just briefly about this piece here on the Harbor Freight winch. Oh, easy, Oswald. Try to knock my camera over. This is the piece that goes in the top here, in this hole that does your clutch engage and disengage? They put such a little tiny shitty amount of grease on there that it isn't lubing anything. Now this big slot is where this your pin sets to keep it from going too far. But this down here that moves your clutch back and forth, and this here whole section will gall up in there if water gets past this O-ring. So I always lube the shit out of these real well. I'll put lube down in that hole too for the clutch. The only winch, the only issue I've ever had with a Harbor Freight winch, I had one of these get gawed up and it ripped the threads out of the ring and I couldn't get it to go back together. The winch still works, just you have to power it in and out, but that's not the point. The point is you need to take that out and lube it up. Just a little Allen screw, excuse me, that holds it in. It's a, looks like a 5/32 size Allen wrench. So enough about that. I'm gonna get this all done, get it out in the sun and give you a better view of what's happened and wrap this bumper build up. All right, viewers, out of the garage, much needed bath after the winter. This looks so good when it's clean. I got to get all this crap off of here still. Of course, get to that rust yuck spot right there. But today we're talking about the bumper. Here it is, black, installed. Mayhaps harder to see, but I really like it. I know my welds aren't filled in and I may go back and fill that stuff in, but I like the way it come around. It's obviously homemade. I don't grind it till you can't see everything because it's clearly been welded. Kind of hard to see the angles and such out here, but I really, really like the look of it. I'll show you what I did with my winch control mount too. Really happy. I am so happy this one turned out great because, like I said, make them up as I go. So I don't really know what they're going to be like until they're done. Let me try maybe a shot of that. So aside from the fair lead sticking out a little bit extra, it doesn't stick out much past where it used to be, the old bumper was. I will go synthetic line and yeah, the line of the Haas fair lead for the line when I get money to do that. I hid the box on the controller. It's right behind there. Let me pop the hood. Okay. So it's just right there. Now it's not touching the condenser. It's resting in there nicely and is zip tied into place. It's not going anywhere. When I have the hood closed, it's real easy to reach my hand up in there and put it in. I've done it several times to make sure that was a good spot. I'll probably plug it in at the beginning anyway, so other people won't have to try and reach their hands up in there and fit it. But yeah, I think with the fair lead mounted back there, it kind of looks like it's missing something there in the front. Maybe not. I mean, there just wasn't enough room to mount the box without cutting this, and I didn't want to cut that. So this is what I got. Do I like it? Yes, I do. Very much so. Skid plates on for underneath there for the radiator as well. That's nice and protected. That's a 3/8-inch piece across the bottom there. Everything on here is either quarter or 3/8, except these pieces inside here, which are 3/16, and the top plate up here, and the top plate up here. Nope, that's quarter. That's also quarter. Okay, I thought I only used 3/16 in a couple places. Okay, so enough about that. Truck's clean, winch bumper's built. I have to build a back one and sliders. Let me know what you think about the fab stuff. Like I say, my fab videos of making bumpers and sliders and things are some of my worst videos as far as views and likes and comments. So if you want to see some more fab stuff, let me know. I love that bumper. Gonna end this for now. Oswald's having a good time. He's just playing water hose. We appreciate you coming out and hanging with us today. Really appreciate the support of all my viewers. You can like and subscribe and comment and click a alert bell if you want to. All those things help me support my show. I would really appreciate it. Those are the things that enable me to continue moving along. Boy, she's pretty, ain't she? Ah, rushed. But anyway, so yeah, please do like if you liked it. Subscribe if you want to see more. Got a lot coming up still. Rear locker, sliders, rear bumper, some other things on the Tundra. Of course, there's a lot on the 4Runner coming up and other things. You know how it goes around here. So thanks for watching Funjunkie Garage. And yeah, thanks for supporting my show. And even if you don't want to click like and subscribe, I still appreciate you watching. So thanks a lot. Have a super great day.